the Exodus or the period of the New Kingdom of Egypt. In the east bank of Luxor, we have like two great temples. One we called it after the name of Karnak Temple, and the second one we called it Luxor Temple. Tonight we are going to visit Luxor Temple, and tomorrow morning we are going to visit El Karnak Temple together. Karnak Temple and Luxor Temple were, two of them were connected with a pavement road. The pavement road was going for 3 miles long, almost something like 5 kilometers, and the road was a pavement road. By the both sides of it we have Sphinx statues. We discover some of those statues, and we discover a part from the road itself, and we do some nice cleaning and restoring of this road. And then we have the rest of the road is still under the ground waiting to be discovered. We know the location of it, but there is some houses for the local people on the top of it especially, and that's what makes the trouble. Now we have one Muslim mosque on the top of the road, and of course the Muslim protesting against the government, saying no way to destroy the mosque to get some ancient idols. And we have a Coptic church on the, also on the top of the road, and also the Coptic community protesting why you would like to destroy the house of God to bring in the house of Satan. So that's what creates some trouble. That's why the project stopped. But I think in the end, the Egyptian government will find a way, when we got the Egyptian government, to solve the problem and continue digging and excavating the roads, because when they finish this one, it will be a very good chance for the tourists who are coming to visit Egypt to go and walk in the same steps where the ancient people who built this civilization were going. So you could imagine how their life looks like and how their places will look like. The only temple open by night, not for a show like sound and light show, it is the Luxor Temple. That's why we do it tonight by night time. It will be illuminated with lights. I will lead you all the way in, explaining every single room, what is the function of it, and giving you like a brief idea about the history of this temple. And then we will end our tour in the back side of the temple. And in your way, coming up back again to the exit, you could take photos as you like. You will be having like a nice free time, let us say almost like half an hour, to wander around in the temple and taking photos inside the temple as you like. You could use your camera and your video camera while we are explaining, and in the free time to take some photos inside the Luxor Temple. After we finish our tour in Luxor Temple, we will use the same bus taking us back again to our cruise, where they will be already serving dinner in the cruise from 7:30, so you could go directly to have your dinner. Unfortunately, I will not be with you during the dinner time, because I need to go to the office to fill some paperwork, you know. Every day I had to make like a report about the tour. When we were in Cairo, Tommy was helping me in that, but here I am the one who had to do it. So that's why, after when you go to have your dinner, I will go to the office to fill some paperwork and finish the paperwork, and then I will join you back in the cruise. My room, my cabin number, by the way, it is 201. If you need to contact me at any time, once we are not doing a tour together, in your free time or something like that, if you'd like to contact me at any time, my cabin is 201. And in the reception, they have my phone number, my mobile number. If I'm out for any reason, they know how to contact me. Just tell them I need to talk to Mido, and they will transfer you and make a phone call and call me. That's the temple we are going to see now. That's Luxor Temple. And I think you know now why we make this one by night time, to enjoy this nice view and nice weather in it.
Luxor seems to be much cleaner than Cairo.
Yeah.
Very much cleaner.